All right, let's get into the very latest on Deshaun Watson. You know, it's let me see. I'm just keeping track here. All right, so it's
50,
so,
60.
Yeah.
How
I was
many
gonna,
we got
yeah, so
point.
So we are looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so like 50-something massage therapists. Nothing to see here, though. Don't worry about it. All normal behavior. But the latest on Deshaun Watson, according to NFL Network's Tom Pelissero, that Deshaun Watson, he's not going to attend OTAs for the Houston Texans, and he still wants out of Houston. All right, he still is demanding a trade. Deshaun Watson still wants no part of the Houston Texans and is still looking to be traded. This following some videos he posted on social media of him working out. And of course, last but definitely not least, the 22 pending lawsuits against him from massage therapists around the country. So here we go. Deshaun Watson still doesn't want to be a Houston Texan, Brady Quinn. And that is where we stand with the Texans quarterback as of now.
That's pretty presumptuous, right? But I guess, you know, that's what you're going to communicate when you feel like you haven't done anything wrong. Now, again, as you point out, and as I've said to you a number of times, I don't know any person, all right, any human being on the face of the planet, unless they've got some sort of addiction to massages, and they have that many different massage therapists. But I can promise you, there is no athlete that would have 50 massage therapists. And the reason why you keep saying 50, there's been 22 separate allegations against Deshaun Watson, but there was also like 22 women who came out in defense of Deshaun Watson, which, you know, when you start adding up all the numbers and the different suits and everything else, that number starts to flirt with 50 different massage therapists. And mind you, he's only played for one team. It'd be something different if he paid for 32 different teams. You'd say, okay, yeah, maybe he's got a different massage therapist he works at in each one of those cities with you know, each different team. That's not the case. So it's very odd that he has that many different massage therapists. I'm not really sure what the explanation is outside of, again, you know, whatever was going on privately or he's got going on in his private life that's now become public. But you know, that's the first red flag and the first reason for there to be cause and suspicion. But it doesn't matter what Deshaun Watson wants at this point. It doesn't. And it really doesn't matter what the Houston Texans want. It only matters what the NFL does. Because we know the legal process is going to take too long. He's not going to be even, you know, he's not going to have to give his sworn deposition until after the Super Bowl. And so unless a settlement takes place, which it could, I mean, there's nothing that says that it couldn't, even though there's 22 separate allegations or lawsuits, they're all represented by the same attorney. And so they could essentially have some sort of boilerplate or standard settlement with each one of the alleged victims, and they could all go on their separate ways. Now, even in that scenario, the NFL still, because this is what Roger Goodell wanted way back when he took over commissioner. He wanted to be the judge, the jury, and the executioner when it came to the player conduct policy within the CBA. So once he signed up for that, and you know, you can go back to the Ray Rice, the Zeke Elliott, other instances of players that had been, you know, suspended for this sort of thing. And usually the minimum was about, what, 6 games?
Yeah.
So they have to do something at some point. It's a bit odd that they haven't acted at this point and put him on the commissioner's exempt list where he gets paid but obviously can't play. And so I'm not sure if they're waiting on a settlement coming and then they can act more swiftly to decide what they want to do or if they're still gathering facts because, again, we've never seen anything like this in sports.
No.
We've never seen something where 22 separate people have come out against someone like this with these lawsuits, you know, all having similar claims. I mean, and this is one of the reasons too why I think when you look at the NFL, you're going, well, they kind of made this bed. Now they've got to lay in it, where they've got to now be, you know, investigators into these sorts of this sort of off the field conduct. So it's a very crazy situation. And honestly, I think it's the NFL's move next. They've got to decide what they want to do with them. It doesn't matter about OTAs, minicamp, and all that stuff, or if he wants to sit out, because I don't know that he's going to be given the opportunity to play based on how the NFL is probably going to end up handling this.
I can't think of another quarterback who's put his team in a worse spot since, what, Michael Vick? Like, honest to God, like, I can't think, like, all the way around, whether it was the issues before all this came out and now where the Atlanta Falcons are, where the Houston Texans, rather, are sitting, I really can't think of a quarterback that's put his team or his organization in a worse spot in recent memory than Deshaun Watson. I mean, like, I feel legitimately bad for the Houston Texans. And I know we're not supposed to do that because everybody wanted to ball wash Deshaun Watson when he was asking for his trade and talk about what a victim he was and all this other stuff. He has put them in such a horrible spot all the way around. I feel bad for everybody involved with the Houston Texans. I swear to God. Feel terrible for him.
I think there's some people who are Deshaun Watson fans that obviously, one, feel like, you know, he's innocent of all this, or at least not guilty. But there's some who feel like Houston hasn't really done right by him in regards to what they've done around the roster. Now, I would push back on that only because they found him a blindside left tackle. They've given him a ridiculous contract. Not saying that it's not warranted. It's deserved. But by the way, they got rid of Hopkins, but they brought in a bunch of other wide receivers. He just is coming off his best statistical year last year. So yeah. I guess you could say what you want. About the position that the Texans are in or that they've put him in. The reality is, I'm kind of with you. Like, I don't know anyone who's been in that position that's wanted to put their team, you know, in the back burner more so than what he's done with this whole entire ordeal.
Yeah, no, and that's a good point, because it's not like Michael Vick didn't want to be a member of the Atlanta Falcons anymore. This stuff right. happened, it blew up in everybody's face, and then, you know, the Falcons were scrambling, trying to figure out, and I remember one of the conversations that were being had back then was, I believe, right before the Michael Vick stuff came out, they had actually moved on from Matt Schaub. And I think Matt Schaub was the backup. And the thought was, oh my God, he put him in a really tough spot because now Matt Schaub's not there. Ultimately, they got it together. They found Matt Ryan and they moved on. And Michael Vick ended up, you know, going to Philadelphia and you know, revitalizing his career. And from all accounts, is a really good dude. And I've heard nothing but good things about him since. That wasn't, he didn't want to do that to the Falcons. Like, Deshaun Watson literally has thrown the Texans under the bus for months, and it's like everybody just looks at it and goes, oh, well, yeah, you know, but they're dysfunctional. Who's dysfunctional here? Like, this sounds like Deshaun Watson's the guy with dysfunction, not the Houston Texans. I don't get it, man. I really don't get this love affair and just the amount of protection that he's gotten from so many people all the way through with this coverage. It's bizarre. Really bizarre. Doesn't make any sense.